For our final talk this evening, we'd like to welcome Lori and her talk called Let's Tangle.
This might look like it's a talk about Morse code, but it's not. These five pen marks up here are the five elemental strokes of the Zentangle method. You've got the dot, the line, the curve, the S-curve, and the circle. This is something that I drew, combining those five elemental strokes. It's really that simple. So what is the Zentangle method? It's a meditative drawing practice created by a husband and wife here in Massachusetts. He's a former monk, so he's kind of a Zen, and she's a calligraphy artist, so we think of her as kind of the Tangle. And the way they describe it is, it's a easy to learn, relaxing, and fun way to create beautiful images by drawing structured patterns. And we call these structured patterns tangles. You'll see that the tangles have reference names on the next slide. And there they are. They're called a few different ones. Tipple, Mollygon, Kiko. They just give them names to make it easier when you're doing your work. So kind of the repeated drawing of these patterns that give you a very calming, soothing experience when you're doing Zentangle. It doesn't require many supplies. It's fairly inexpensive, unlike the basket. This is very cheap. It's paper, pencil, high-quality black marker, and that little thing on the left is a blending tool that I use for shading. More than the supplies, really, is kind of the ritual of Zentangle. It really engages your mind and your body, and you kind of get yourself prepared before you do the work. You just get relaxed, and you think about what you're gonna do, because it's very a mindful practice. You draw your tangles, and you take some time to really reflect and be very intentional. It's not something that you do when you're watching TV or chatting on the phone. It stands alone. You sign your work when you're finished to show that you appreciate it, just to remind yourself that you really took time to be creative, and it's that's really important to the practice, is that you're thinking about what you're doing, reflecting on appreciation and gratitude for being creative. Some of the work you see looks a little simple, some might look a little more complex, but it's really all quite simple just by using the five elemental strokes that I talked about before, so it makes it really accessible. Anybody can really do this practice. And many people have found it, again, very relaxing and calming, and so they use it for pain management, stress reduction, focus and attention. They feel is increased when they use the Zentangle method. A lot of people have come from all across the globe, really, to Massachusetts to learn about it from the founders and to become maybe a CZT, which is a Certified Zentangle Teacher. When I did my certification class, I met people from Singapore, Belgium, Taiwan, Germany, and all across the United States that wanted to come and learn about it. It's being taught and practiced now in just about every country in the world. The next slide is going to be a circular tile that I did, and this one's called a mandala, which is based on the traditional mandala style of art. This has several different tangles in it and some shading. I usually work on small pieces of paper like that, the traditional ones, but this one that you see now is a very large piece. I think it's about a 12 by 16 maybe, matted and framed, hanging in my friend's house. The next work that I did was, I had some fun at Christmas time with some ceramic ornaments. I did a lot of tangles on them and gave those away as gifts. But I do traditionally work on paper. The next slide you'll see is, I got a little silly and used frosting to tangle a birthday cake for my friend Susan, who also really likes Zentangle. So basically, wrapping up, it's a Zentangle method is a meditative drawing style with involves ritual and intention. It's really easy. Anyone can do it. It doesn't take a lot of money or supplies or space to do it. You really can take it anywhere. And it's very gratifying work. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Lori.